This is the story of Reginald Saunders. He was born in 1920 on the 7th of August. His father was a veteran of the First World War. His mother died when he was a child, only four. He left school at 14, got a job in the sawmills, but he always knew when he was older he'd be joining the fight for his country. Just like his father and his uncle had before him, soon so will be his younger brother, Harry. Well, he enlisted in 1940 on the 24th of April, and only 6 weeks later was promoted to Lance Corporal. His first deployment was the Middle East in 2nd 7th Battalion, where he survived the shower of bombs over being dropped by the Germans. They say he was a natural leader and respected by his men. Yeah, they never saw the color of his skin. They just saw the man. At 42, a sergeant, he fought New Guinea with great courage and honor. He said being a bush boy, he always felt more comfortable in the jungle with all that cover. He was fearless in battle and a natural leader. And in 1944, he became the first Aboriginal to be commissioned officer. He held the respect of all his land. They said they gladly followed him to the battle wherever that he came. They never saw the color of his skin. Nah, they just saw the man. Well, at the end of the war, he returned to Australia with the news that he had lost his younger brother. And his wife and three daughters that he left behind also moved on to start over with their lives. In 1950, he returned to the army, fought in Korea, and led 200 men in Charlie Company. He led without question in the Battle of Capion, but he enlisted again in 54 to become a civilian once again. He held the respect of all his men. They never saw the color of his skin. I just saw the man. Well, a man of dignity, he fought for his people until he passed away on the 2nd of March of 99. Lest we forget Captain Reginald Saunders. And courage doesn't matter, anything is possible. His men didn't see the color of his skin. They just saw the man.